we're so excited about this story. For over 50 years, she's been considered the Queen of King's Cross. Our Carlotta has seen it all, from gangsters to white witches and more feathers than you could shake a boa at. And now Craigie Bennett joins Carlotta in her old stomping ground to walk down memory lane.
This was the first part of the cross that I knew.
Right.
When I first came across, the Coca-Cola sign wasn't there. There was a big Dunlop sign.
Really?
Yes.
So Dunlop was the top of the town here in the cross?
That's right. This was a famous pink pussycat.
Where's Mrs. Slocum when you
need
her? We had
a great big photograph of a girl on a black and pink.
So what was it, a strip club?
It was a strip club, yes.
Gosh, if it was still happening, we could be working there next week.
That's right, that's right.
You never know your luck in a big city.
Carlotta, this was perhaps one of the most famous hotels in Australia, the old Hampton Court.
Well, it was. You know, they've overpainted it and the verandas were different. They've closed them in.
Elizabeth Taylor.
But Elizabeth Taylor stayed here with Mike Todd.
That's right, when they came for Around the World in 80 Days. 1956, why do I know these things?
I was about there.
Wow.
I was closer. She came out.
And she came down
these
stairs.
Well, the front entrance was a bit better than those days.
Now, probing question, Carlotta. did you ever spend a night or two or maybe even three up there?
Why is everyone interested in my love life?
Because you have such an interesting love life, we imagine.
Yes, I had quite a few affairs in this hotel.
Did you really?
But we're not going to name
anyone
names.
Famous?
No, we're not going to name
names.
No,
we are going to name names.
No, we're not. No,
there's
we're
no
not. No,
listening.
No, come on, we're going to go down.
It's only you and me.
Shut up.
Look, there you go.
Yeah, look, they've got me in cement.
Ta-da! Well, here we are, Carlotta. This was your home away from home for how many years?
36 years.
Lay Girls.
Before I was working at Lay Girls, I was a hairdresser. I am a fully qualified hairdresser. But at the moment, I'm making more money doing this.
What were those days like?
Well, you know, we were kids and we just thought it was magical. But, you know, years later I realised how much money they made out of us.
Is that
you know,
right?
We were like slave labour. And it was just years later when the Americans and the R&R came and the drugs started to appear here that it sort of all went downhill. I think, well, look, it's part of history and that'll never change.
Well, this was the bourbon and beef.
This is what everyone around the world came to see. It was known for its fabulous food.
And music.
Yeah, and music. Wonderful bands appeared here. I appeared here later on. I think I'm on the second floor upstairs. I think I'm in wallpaper up here too.
My gosh. I mean, you literally own the cross.
Yeah, it's amazing I'm not on toilet paper.
Well, of course, Carlotta, the famous all round the world, the El Alamein fountain. Tell me you went swimming in there one night after maybe a refreshment.
Darling, I fell
just
in.
Just once?
Darling, I fell in there a few nights.
I had a feeling you'd fallen into that fountain maybe once or twice.
Well, we were all young and stupid then.
Oh, now we're just stupid.
That's a famous Rex Hotel there.
So it is.
It's very chic now. I'd say it was the first sort of gay and straight place.
Oh.
Yes.
So they did mix. The oil and the water actually did
it sort of did mix in those days.
Wow.
Yeah. Sunday afternoons we used to go there, the beer garden at the back.
When the moon is in the seventh house.
See, this is one good thing. They never changed the out part of this building or the Roosevelt next door. This is where they had Hair the musical. I remember, and Susie Wong, they had the street blocked off and had all the Chinese entertainers in the street. And the red carpet went from here right up there. Oh, I got mugged on the way home from the bourbon and beef. I was there where that mattress is, but that mattress wasn't there. And
no.
Someone...
Mind you, it could have been.
They hit me on the back of the head with a piece of wood and I had a bit of concussion. That's probably why I'm a dilly lily. And but they found my... I was furious because I had my Chanel handbag and they took it and the police were fabulous because they used to look after me in those days. And over there at the park, they found my bag. He was going through my bag and they got my credit cards, everything back.
Give me a head with hair. long.
Oh, now see this place here?
Yes, I do.
This is what used to be the famous Cashmere Coffee Lounge.
Oh, wow.
Where Rosalind Norton, the White Witch, she had all the famous paintings in there.
A White Witch?
But it was famous, this coffee lounge.
And now it's an optometrist.
Of course, yes, I believe, and I went blind over
here. Everything changed. I know why you went blind.
Ah, yes, I know. And it didn't have anything to do.
Your mother told you, love.
Didn't have anything to do with Peter Allen either.
Hey, a little girl.
Silver Spade, that was a famous Chevron hotel.
One of the most famous showrooms in all of Australia.
Silver Spade and Natalie Cole.
You did her weeks, didn't you?
Yeah, Carmen McRae. Everybody that came to Australia in those days, Bobby Rydell, all of them, they all appeared. Unforgettable.
Well, snap your garter and call me
yes,
Lulu.
Yes, I know, darling. That's it's sad, isn't it?
To think it's become Joe the Juice Bar. Yeah.
To me, the cross, it's lost its orb.
Do you think the lockout laws have had a lot to do with that?
I think the lockout laws have ruined the cross. It's ruined Sydney. Because I remember going to America when I was very young and people couldn't wait to go to King's Cross. They couldn't wait to see the pink pussycat. They couldn't wait to see the bourbon and beef. This strip down here was vibrant, even of a daytime.
And look at the joint now. It's kind of had it, hasn't it?
No, darling, no. I wouldn't even put my garbage bin out here now.
On that story to big hello to Carlotta who is watching us this morning. You've got a bit of a story about the bourbon and beef store.
It was lovely when Carlotta was talking about the bourbon and beef store. Beefsteak. It was just so fabulous. Always had live music, a great band. And I remember, you know, in the 80s, I knew if I was staring at the band that was there and there was a sign above the bandstand that said, you cannot soar with the eagles in the morning if you stay up with the turkeys at night. And I knew when I was reading that sign, I'm going, oh, tomorrow's going to be a really hard day.
Did you ever sing there? Did you ever get up and join in?
Yeah, I can't.
That may have happened?
Yeah, I think that may have happened. May have happened, yeah. But it was great. The live music and the cross was pumping in those
days.
Yeah. It has been ruined, I think.
And who'd have thought that all these years later you'd be waking up with turkeys every day? Hey, like us.